Good morning. Today we're going to discuss the reality of our first free body diagram.
Hey guys.
Hey Bob.
Hi Bob.
Flippin' physics.
I was just pushing on a book using a force sensor, and the free body diagram of all the forces acting on the book looked like this. The force of gravity is down, the force normal is up, the force applied is to the right, and the force of friction is to the left. We drew all of those forces coming from a dot at the center of the object. Billy, what is the name of that dot?
It is called the center of mass.
Correct. But the reality is that only the force of gravity acts on the center of mass of the object. This is what the free body diagram really looks like. Because the force normal, force applied, and force of friction are all contact forces, they should all be drawn on the book at their points of contact. You can see that the force applied acts on the book where the force sensor is in contact with the book, and the force of friction and the force normal act on the book where the book is in contact with the surface of the table. In fact, we draw the force normal just a little bit to the left of where it should be so that it doesn't overlap the force of gravity. So this is where we start with free body diagrams, and this is where we're headed with free body diagrams. Now, I equate it to how we learn about projectile motion. When we first start learning about projectile motion, we ignore air resistance. Actually, we spend a lot of time ignoring the air that is all around us. Eventually, we add air resistance and include the force of drag. That makes the solutions more accurate, which is great. However, including the force of drag makes the math exceptionally more complicated, and that definitely would not be a good place to start. The same is true for free body diagrams. We start with all the forces acting on the center of mass of the object, which is easier. And when we get to the concept of torque, we start concerning ourselves with exactly where the forces act on the object, which is more accurate, but more complicated. Don't worry though, we have a lot of physics to learn before we get to the concept of torque and these types of free body diagrams. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Why are you so small?
What do you mean?
You're, like, tiny.
Yeah, you are minuscule.
Really? I feel normal.
Well, you don't look normal.
Does anybody see a piece of cake labeled "Eat Me" around here? Because that would be really helpful.